गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल. सो वी विल मूव टू द लास्ट इश्यूज, दैट इज कंसोलिडेशन. ओके, व्हाट आर द इश्यूज? ओके, सी कंसोलिडेशन मीन्स वी कैन से द एक्शन. ओके, कंसोलिडेशन मीन्स वी कैन से एक्शन और वी कैन से प्रोसेस ऑफ मेकिंग समथिंग. प्रोसेस ऑफ making something means nowadays what are the banks are facing n number of issues. Consolidation means how we can overcome with this problem, or what are the some actions we can take or we can make something to overcome the issues. Like we have profitability issue, like we have banking reforms, means where we have getting n number of rules and regulations, it may by RBI, and the income recognition is not receiving on periodical way of time, as well as we have supervision issues. Means nowadays various new institutions have been came into the market, like merchant bank, leasing, for them various supervisions and regulated they have given. Next, last issue is consolidation, means to make some action. See, primary aim of the solution of major issue of the Indian financial system is not only to consolidate. Consolidate is not only to take actions. What are the gains made in the financial sector? Means we cannot take some actions against what are the bank have been gained in the previous year or the current, or the profit they are getting. Other than that, what are the banks are gaining profit? Other than that also, but the financial institutions, means banks, must also improve the quality of their portfolio. Apart from their gain, what are the profit they have gaining in financial sector? Apart from that also, this financial sector also should improve the quality of their portfolio. Means what are the services they are providing? Portfolio means what are the various services they are providing. It should be provided in better quality. Better quality means portfolio means what are the services the financial sector are providing, like accepting the deposits or telling about bonds, what are the cash held by individuals. Means portfolio means what are the main, what are the services the banks are providing, that the quality should be improved. Means the portfolio should be improved, providing greater operational flexibility and greater autonomy. Autonomy means Swantantri, autonomy means Swantviyavanmadu, who have their own autonomy, means of their internal operation, of their internal operation of all the financial institutions, so that they can take care of their health, competitive and vibrant financial sector. Okay, if they are providing better quality of services, or the improving their better quality of portfolio, means it will be greater flexibility create, so the financial institutions can run smoothly and competitive. And other than that, there are the various weaknesses facing from financial sector, or we can say financial institutions, various weakness they are facing. Like they have some political pressures or administrative interference. Some interference is happening, means political interference is happening, administrative interference, or some trade union interference is happening, or trade union pressures are there. Some politicians will say some appoint some of their candidates. So this all must be eliminated by the financial sector to improve their growth and to improve the flexibility of the bank. And if this adequate and efficient measures will be taken, means apart from seeing that profit, apart from providing quality services and reducing some political interference, trade union administration, if this such will be reduced or eliminate means all this improve, if it will happen, means automatically the health of this financial sector will be improve and it will be strong. So that is called as consolidation. Okay, understood about consolidations? Means solving some issues. What are the issues banks are facing? Means usually banks, we should not see about the gains, what are the profit they have made, and also we should improve the quality, and also we should improve the internal organizations. Means within the organizations, what the work is happening, we should take care of that. If this happened, as well as some weaknesses this financial sector are facing, means like political interference, some administrative, like trade unions, this all should be reduced, all should be eliminated by the bank. If this happened, means where the bank can be under a healthy and competitive way of manner. Okay, so this was about the issues which we have studied. Okay, like quick I will revise from first what are the various issues. Hope you know the meaning of issues. Means what are the problems they are problems we are facing in Indian financial system. Like we have first issue, bank capital adequacy. Means bank capital adequacy means we can say that the bank should maintain some proper means they should maintain some fund in their bank for coming future occurrence. What are the chance, means what are some problems the bank can face, they can use those amount for their bank capital adequacy. Means RBI, means usually banks are regulated and controlled by Reserve Bank of India. For this purpose, this regulatory body will say that they should maintain some minimum capital in their bank, means minimum fund they should save. Usually this capital has been divided into two tier, as I told, tier 1, tier 2. I'm talking about first issues. Means tier 1, tier 2. Means in tier 2 consists that we should maintain some paid up capital, meaning I have explained of paid up capital, and they should also maintain some statutory reserve and some disclosed reserve, means giving some information to the public about their shares, what share price is there, how much shares they are receiving, that they should take. Bank capital means an amount of money they have in the bank. And tier 2 capital, as I told, tier 2 capital consists of undisclosed reserve, means where we cannot disclose some information, or we cannot leak information of certain banks outside the market, we should not link. As well as we have cumulative preference shares, I have told, revaluation reserve, I have told. So this was about the bank capital issue, means bank adequacy capital, means a bank should maintain some minimum capital. Second was income recognition. Means suppose usually banks will lend their money. Usually bank will lend their money to other people, means they provide money to other whoever needs on interest basis. Whatever the money they are lending and what are the interest they used to get, they should get the interest on periodic way of manner. Means the bank should get interest on proper way of time. If they if they are getting the interest on time, means If they are getting interest on time, means they can reinvest those amount in other companies. For them also they can earn profit. That is called a simple income recognition. Means whatever the bank have lended the money, it may be to individuals, it may be to the businessmen, or it may be to the organizations. What they have lended money to the others means those interest amount and other amount which are they are getting, they should get on in on proper way of time, means on periodic way of time, that is of income recognition. Okay, income recognition means the bank should get interest on proper way of time. If they have get in proper way of time, means they can reinvest. Okay, as I told, as well as if they're not getting interest on time, means the bank will lose its flexibility. The bank may can lose its flexibility in the market, or in that there were three issues which I have explained: the liquidity, the non-performing loans, or on the balance sheet. Okay, liquidity means whenever the bank will get interest, means then only we should treat that as a income. Okay, until unless the interest received in cash, then only we should treat it as a income. Okay, in income recognition means whatever the interest bank is getting, it should be converted into cash, then only we can treat it as income. Until unless we cannot treat, if it is income is getting, then only we can transfer into P&L account. Until unless we cannot mention in that we are getting. And one more, non-performing loans. Okay, usually we have two types of non-performing loans, means two types of debt. So one we have debt, and one more we have bad debt. Okay, this debt amount where we can easily recoverable, where we can easily recover. When coming to the bad debts, so this amount where easily we cannot recoverable. So this bad debts we should make some effort to recover that. So this was about the various problems we face in income recognition. And one more we have profitability. Okay, profitability means the health of the financial system is reflected by its profitability. Means how much profit the bank is earning. It will means the health of the, we can say the health of the financial system is always reflected by the productivity, how it is efficiency and how much profitability is there in the market. Means it is, means the productivity should be high and the profitability of the bank should be high, and it should have some fairly adequate, then only we can consider that this financial system is healthy and sound. Means it is in good manner. Means usually it is earning huge profit or a high rate or in high market, then only we can say that this bank is healthy and sound. If it is not up to the mark, means we can say that this Indian financial system or financial sector is not up to the mark. Okay, certain problem we can, if you're not earning that much profit, means certain problems we can face, means like unprofitability will be happened, we cannot expand our the business, or certain low productivity will be happening. So these were the problems happens in profitability. And some other fourth issue that we have, banking reforms. Why I'm repeating this issues means it is an important topic, important questions. It may ask for 15 marks. Okay, banking reforms. Banking reforms means some rules and regulations. We can say rules and regulations, which is prescribed by RBI. Okay, we can say that rules and regulation should be must be follow, must be given to the banks. But over rules and regulations should be not given. Means rules and regulations is compulsory for the banks. Okay, we can say that rules and regulations should be compulsory, but it should not be sorry, means that rules and regulations are compulsory, but it should not be over rules and regulations, which it will be headache to the banks. Whether they should concentration on rules and regulations, or they should concentration on the bank. Okay, earlier means rules and regulation. Why it is compulsory means to show that public. Why rules and regulations are compulsory means to show the public that this bank is following certain rules and regulations, which is guided by the RBI. For that purpose, you can show. But this over means where the rules and regulations should be not over means ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರಬಾರ್ದು. ಅದ್ರ ಹೆಡ್ಡೇಕ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್. ವೆದರ್ ದೇ ಶುಡ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೂಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ ಶುಡ್ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದೇರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಿಂಗ್ ರಿಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೂಪರ್ವಿಷನ್ಸ್. ಸೂಪರ್ವಿಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಸಮ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೂಪರ್ವೈಸ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಡೂ. ಸೂಪರ್ವಿಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ in supervising the banks, whether they are working efficiently with the certain rules and regulations or certain guidelines they are following or not. Okay, like in past years certain new institutions have been came into the market, like merchant banking we have. Okay, merchant bank we have, leasing, leasing we have, and we have mutual funds. So these are the various newly institutions, financial institutions came into the market. Whether we should make them supervise, whether they are following the standard rules and regulations or not. Okay, they should it will be regulated by, if it is bank means, if it is bank means it is regulated by, supervised by RBI. So if it is in stock market, so it is can be regulated by SEBI. Okay, this was about the supervisions, and as well as we have studied about capital market and money market. Hope you know the meaning of capital and money. Money means where we can lend and borrow the money for short term. Okay, and capital means for long term. Okay, we can lend and money for long term, that is capital. When this money market and capital market means when this liberalization have came into India, means LPG liberalizations, privatizations and globalization. When this privatization have been made existence in the market, means they have included that capital and money market into privatization also. They have included this capital and money market. Okay, they have included this. Okay, like companies are permitted issues or any debt instruments. Some changes they have made when these privatizations have included capital and money market into that. Some changes they have made, like usually when you used to issue treasury bills, the time, the date means it used to 91 days or 3 months instead. Now they have changed. We can repay into 182 days or 364 days. Within 1 year we can pay. Some changes they have made. Like we have new institutions like Stock holding means we have some new institutions like OTCI, over the counter exchange of India. It may ask for 2 months. 2 months expand. The previous paper has asked OTCI over the counter exchange of India. We have means they have to set up means according to the standard rules and regulations by SEBI means they have made the changes in capital and money market. So this we have studied issues, and from starting we'll do some revisions. Hope you know the meaning of financial system. Okay, financial system you can say mainly lending and borrowing of money. Means keep it in mind, financial system means lending the money and borrowing the money to the various, it may be means lending money, it will be to individuals, it may be groups, partnerships, or it may be to the companies. Lending the money means giving loans to the whoever needs. Simple meaning. If you study textbook meanings, means it is an interrelated activities. Okay, financial system, we can say it is an interrelated activity, services working together. Means who are those interrelated activities? Means like we say financial market, we have financial institutions, financial instruments, or we have financial services. They work as an interrelated activities. What they will work for the purpose of achieving some predetermined goals. Means they can borrow or they can lend the money. So this was a meaning. Simple meaning means financial system, it is a lending and as well as means providing lending and borrowing of money. We have studied meaning, and we have some objectives in your syllabus. Okay, like we have to mobilize saving. Okay, objectives meaning we have completed just now, and we have objectives. We have objectives, mobilize saving. Mobilize savings means collecting of money. Okay, the most important objective of the financial system is to mobilize savings. Mobilize means collecting of money. It may be from individuals. See, mobilize of saving means, suppose I have some, we can say 1 lakh rupees, okay, which have been deposited in a bank. Okay, mobilize of saving means, suppose I have a 1 lakh rupees which I have deposited in bank. What does bank, the bank which I have deposited will not kept as it is. This bank, what they will do, whoever needs some amount, they will give loan to the other on an interest, on an interest basis. Interest basis. Bank is also of earning profit. I am also some earning. The bank will give some interest, and whoever needs the loan, they are also getting some profit. That is called as mobilize of saving. Collecting of money from others. It may be individual, business, and lending the money, whoever want to needs the money. And next we have the financial system may also help to provide fund for rapid economic development. Rapid economic development means this, we have developing countries, like we have example like India. For there also some India required some money, means they also can help to those country for developing their rapid economic development, to improve the economic development of the country, of developing countries. They will help this financial system in lending the money. As well as we have third objective, to provide service essential in modern economy. Okay, this means the financial system aims providing services for lending and borrowing. In this, we have certain three different sectors, entities. It may be individuals, it may be businesses, or we have government. These are the main three different sectors in to provide service essential. See, in individual, what happened? Those who have surplus amount, those who have surplus amount means saving amount, who have some saving amount, they become some lenders. Suppose who don't have surplus amount, they will become borrowers. They will become borrowers in individuals. Second is business. Of course, businesses are, sometimes they mean some borrowers. Of course, they are borrowers. And government, usually government will be having some big borrowers who borrow some money. Next, we have to provide liquidity in the market. Financially, the aim of the financial system of a country is to provide liquidity, means converting monetary assets, okay, monetary assets into cash. It will help. And we have another objective. It will be, it may establish a strong link between, they work as a, to maintain a good relation between saving and investments. Okay, usually financial system, what they will do, they make better link relationship between savings and as well as investment. So this we have objectives, and we have, hope you know this, we have some organizational structure of Indian financial system. Okay, hope you know it. It is also a compulsory question. Okay, we have some, wait a minute, sorry. See, we have a structure of Indian financial system. So all we have completed. Okay, first we have completed about financial market. Okay, financial market means where we can say it is a place where we can buy and sell our securities. Okay, next, it has divided into organized and unorganized. In organized means which follow some standard rules and regulations. Okay, in that we have money market and capital market. Money market means which is for short term period of time, that is for 1 year. In money market, where we want to buy any borrow money, it is for short term period, that is for 1 year. And we have capital market. Capital market is for long term. Okay, in capital market we have another, primary and secondary market. Okay, in unorganized means where does not follow some standard rules and regulations, where we have some money lenders, indigenous banks, or also earlier there was Marwadis people, they used to come under they also come under organized Marwadis. Here what happens in unorganized, where the interest rate will be high. Whenever they lend the money to the other peoples, where the interest rate will be high, they will work like as a same banking. They will also work like a depositing money, accepting the money, but where the interest rate will be high. That we have studied. And one more, we have second classification or organized, we have studied financial institutions. Okay, financial institution we have studied. Financial institution means where are those tradable instruments which have some monetary value. Financial institutions we have studied. In that also we have organized sector and unorganized sector we have studied. And one more, financial instrument we have studied. In that we have marketable securities and non-marketable securities. Okay, marketable securities means which the securities which can easily be marketable or ट्रेडेबल मार्केटेबल एसेट्स और सिक्योरिटीज मीन्स ओके मार्केटेबल सिक्योरिटीज मीन्स विच कैन इजिली ट्रेडेबल वेयर वी कैन बाय एंड सेल एंड वेयर वी कैन इजिली ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम वन पर्सन टू अनदर पर्सन दैट इज कॉल्ड एज मार्केटेबल एसेट्स ओके लाइक वी हैव शेयर्स डिबेंचर्स बॉन्ड्स गवर्नमेंट सिक्योरिटीज वेयर वी कैन इजिली मार्केटेबल मीन्स वी कैन बाय एंड वी कैन सेल एंड वन मोर नॉन मार्केटेबल मीन्स वेयर वी कैन नॉट ट्रेडेबल वेयर वी कैन नॉट बाय और सेल लाइक वी हैव पेंशन फंड प्रोविडेंट फंड बैंक डिपॉजिट इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसीज वेयर वी कैन नॉट इजिली ट्रांसफरेबल वी हैव स्टडीड ओके ऑर्गेनाइजेशन स्ट्रक्चर we have completed it is also important for 15 marks organizational structure of Indian financial system and major issues in Indian financial system compulsory both question may come for 15 marks okay issues we have completed structure organizational structure in that financial market financial institution financial instrument we have completed okay as well as we have studied financial services also it may also come financial services nothing but which provides some services to the people okay financial services like providing credit card facilities providing some installment facilities they will provide in that also we have studied about financial services classification also like asset based and fee based In asset based, we have equipment, hire purchase, and a number loan syndications, venture capital. In asset based, in fee based, we have studied about some merchant banking, etc. We have completed, and one more composition of Indian financial system. In that also, we have organized and unorganized market. In organized, same money and capital. In unorganized also, we have like money lenders. Indigenous banks traders landlords so this we have completed and also we have functions okay so with this overall we have completed our first unit okay so within 1 or 2 days I will give some notes for you okay hope you have understood about all first unit that is about introduction Now coming to the second unit, we have financial market. Second unit is about financial market. In that we have meaning, characteristics, classifications. In that and second one more we have added that is money market. In that meaning, functions we will study. Okay, in coming class, we will study about financial market.